Alright guys, welcome back to Weld.com. I'm your guest host, Brian Legallo. We're at Marksman Technical College, where I work every day as the lead instructor. Today we're going to go over some fit up on some pipe. This is a common problem new students or new welders have with pipe. These tricks and these techniques I'll show you will make your life a whole lot easier welding this. All right, so these are flame cut right here. I'm gonna take a flapper disc, I'm gonna knock down all the oxide layer and the dross, and I'm gonna try to make these as consistent to each other as possible. Once I get them all shiny and cleaned up, I'm gonna knock down the root face. I'm gonna put about a 3/32 root face on them, and I'm gonna, when I tack them up, I'm gonna have about a 3/32 gap. Just simple. All right guys, I just got done cleaning these up. They're not bad. I'm gonna take down the root face, make it about a 3/32 of a root face right here. I'm gonna use this wire as a little reference point. I'm gonna go around, try to make these things exactly the same or as close as I can. All right guys, I got the first one done. I'm gonna knock out this one real quick. All right guys, what I made here was, we call them keys. And they're just a 90 degree bend of your gap wire with a flat spot. If you use this technique, which I use this quite often, it'll get stuck. What you can do with these, but this is quicker, you can do with these as soon as you get it tacked up, you can rotate to the flat spot, slide them out every time, or almost every time. Even if that gap shrinks up a little bit for you. So you make a set of these for your preferred gap sizes, 3/32, 1/8, 5/32, and you can keep them in your welding bag. They're not a one-use thing. So we have this this high-low gauge. It's like the wire type. When I'm making my fit, this tells me if it's high-low, and then I can use this other side right here, put in the gap, and it'll tell me my gap width at that point. So now I'm not eyeballing it, I know exactly what my gap is. Machine wedges. These are hardened tool steel wedges. These will move some pipe around. If I'm worried about a gap closing up, I'll shove one of these in there. But this is another tool to make sure I can move this gap around, because as I'm tacking it, it's gonna shrink towards my direction of travel. So I'm gonna have to open it up even after my first tack. And then, of course, you gotta move metal around. Gotta have something, a persuader, if you will. I gotta, safety first, I have to put my gloves on before I handle material. I'm gonna take this guy, shove it right there, or set it, I don't know why I'm shoving anything. Put it right there. I'm gonna take my wire gauge, and I'm gonna start checking out my high-low. High-low, I can read it right here on the end, and I can correct it as I need. I'm gonna check my gap. I know we haven't put a tack in this yet, but let's just see where it sits, and I wanna show you how to use this gauge. So I'm gonna push it in. So put it in the bevel. I'm gonna hold it with my fingers, and now I can check exactly where my fit up is. Do I look good?
Oh, you look great, man.
It's nice working with you, Todd. All right, guys, so we just worked on our fit up. We got everything, or almost everything, cleaned up, and we're ready to tack up. We're gonna set up this AHP. Get ready to go. I've never ran an AHP welder before. I just got this AHP 225 in. I'm excited to try it out. We're gonna run this about 75 amps on DC electrode positive. All right, I'm gonna tack this thing up with some Bowler 6010. She slapped. I'm gonna put four tacks. I'm gonna quarter it, you know, equal sides, quarter tacks. They're gonna be about 3/8 long, you know, give or take an eighth. I want them a little longer, even if they're specified a quarter inch. If I make them 3/8 or a half inch, I can ramp them in and out, preparing for my root pass. If I just make them a quarter inch as per procedure, I don't have a whole lot of meat there to manipulate as far as for tie-ins. Before I tack up this quarter, I wanna make sure my gap is consistent with what I want. I want a 3/32 gap with a 3/32 land. So I'm a little over an eighth inch, so I'm gonna take the little persuader here. I'm gonna give it a little tap, and I'm gonna check again with my goal of being, try to hit a 3/32 or at least close to it. Looks like we're good. Alright guys, now that I have two tacks in this thing, I'm gonna start pulling out my keys. I can remove the tape now, and I can take that key, rotate it, and pull it out. Most of the time, at this point, you're fighting to get your gap wire out of here. That's why we have this flat spot here, so I can make that little rotation, that 90 degree rotation, pull straight out. Now it's half the thickness. Come on the other side here, really good tape. And I'm still gonna check my gap with my gap gauge and make sure if I need to tap it either direction, I'm gonna tap it and make sure it's going the way I want. But right there, I'm a little over 332, which is pretty good. All right guys, so I have two tacks on here. I'm gonna put my next two, so four in total. I'm gonna tack right here on this quarter. As soon as I'm done with this tack, I'm gonna spin this relatively quickly and I'm gonna make my next tack. I'm doing this in an effort to keep the distortion low on this piece so I don't open up one side. Everything Irie. All right guys, I found a piece of filler metal that the old camera guy was hiding from me. Here's that 332 wire. It's not quite going in, but it's almost going in. Not bad, like right there. Pretty good. All right guys, this is how I tack up a 6010 root pipe. And really, just a little bit of prep on the root face and the gap would change for TIG. But I make this consistent as I can every time. But I hope these tips help. I hope this is something that will help you in the future. Pass that next weld test. Well, if you're having trouble with your root, more than likely it's your consistency and fit up. And if you can make your fit up more consistent, you can start diving into other factors of amperage and stuff like that, or technique, if you know your fit up's the same every time. This is how I do it. Hope this helps.